Yes, good morning students. Today we will start with the poem The Pilgrim. So last time we have completed this poem, so today we will have the revision of this poem The Pilgrim. This poem Pilgrim, it is penned or written by anonymous. We don't know the unknown person is there. So each stanza, the rhyme scheme is different in this poem. So here we will see in this poem, different rhyme schemes and the stanzas are also have different lines there. So now about a pilgrim. So pilgrim means the person who goes to worship, okay, to a pilgrimage, to a particular temple or any place where the God is worshipped. So a pilgrim going alone highway. So when a pilgrim was going alone on the highway, came at evening cold and gray. So it was, he came back in the evening, and in the evening it was chilling cold and gray there, means everything we can't see it properly, it was dark there. To a chasm deep and vast and wide. Chasm means here a river, that is a very deep, deep gap between the earth's surface, so that is known as the chasm, which was very deep, very big and wide. The old man crossed in the twilight dim, as it was in the evening, so he couldn't see it properly. So however, he crossed it because he usually used to travel in those roads, so he knew the way. The chasm held no fear for him, and this deep gap between the earth, the ravine, it held no fear for him. He was not at all afraid because he was knowing the way. But he paused when he reached the other side. But after crossing that river, he paused there. He stopped there for some time and built a bridge to span the tide. To span the tide means to across the, go across the tide. And there he, after stopping there on the other side, he built a bridge. He bridged so that when the tide will be there at that time, people will find it easy to cross the road. Old man said, a fellow pilgrim near, why waste your time in building here? So a fellow pilgrim was there. He told, you are old and why are you wasting time in building here? Because you are old now again, when you will come or not, it is not in our hands. Your journey ends with the close of the day. Now your life is too short remained, and you will end your life anytime. So now with the close of the day, your journey will also be over. So why are you building? You again will not travel because now you are grown old. You never again will pass this way. So he told him directly that you will never again come on this path. So why are you building it? At that way, you have crossed the chasm deep and wide. Why build ye here at even time? So when the tide is there, means that is in the, it is the late evening, it is dark. And why are you doing this type of work? So when you have crossed the chasm deep and wide, you have already crossed it. So why are you building it here? The pilgrim raised his old gray hair. So pilgrim who was working there building the bridge, so he raised his head, which was old and gray. Why? Because white-haired. My friend in the path, I have come, he said, there followed after me today. So when I was coming to my path, after me were many passengers who were following me today. A fair-haired youth who must pass this way. So there was a youth, a young person was also. Now he will be also coming and he will cross this way. The chasm which held no fears for me to the fair-haired youth may be a pitfall me. Well, that this chasm, I know it very well. I have no fear of the, of this ravine river there. But the young lad who is coming after me, it may be a great trap for him, dangerous for him. He may fall in that path. He too must cross in the twilight dim. And whenever he will come, he will also cross in the dark only, in the twilight, in the evening time. So my friend, I am building this bridge for him. So this is the poem that I am not doing for myself because I know the way. I have passed the way. But for the coming generations, I am building this bridge so that they will not find any difficulty to cross the bridge, to cross the river, whenever they will come in the dark. So which lesson we get from this? That is, we should help and think always about the others or our coming generation also. When we are asked that we should make India pollution free, means that is not for us. We are making safe this country for the coming generation. So as we have got the freedom and our ancestors have given as a gift freedom to us, so now what is our duty? We should safeguard our freedom. So in the same manner, our ancestors have thought about coming generation. So we should also think about the coming generation. So this poem, which is written by anonymous, means the unknown person. And there, if you see, no rhyme scheme in each of the stanzas there. So that is, and the figure of speech, if we discuss, many figures of speech are there. Climax is there, tautology is there, alliteration is there. So many figures of speech are used in the poem. And what is the central idea? That is, we should think for others. We should make easy way for others. If we have faced the difficulty, then we have to find out the solutions for the coming generation, so that as we have wasted time in solving the problem, they should not waste, they should get the things, because many difficulties and many challenges are always there in our life. So here in the second line, came at evening cold and gray. Cold and gray, this is a climax, because one after the other, the words are arranged in ascending order. Now, third line, to a chasm, deep and vast and wide. Vast and wide, that is a tautology again, and climax. Tautology means vast and wide. Vast matlab bhi bahut bada hota, wide also a big, in big width. So that is also a tautology, and climax, deep, vast and wide. So vast and wide, it can be the alliteration also. Then next one, the chasm held no fear for him. The chasm is river. River gives no fear to me. So river has been personified there. And built a bridge to span. That time built a bridge. So it is alliteration. And in the next line, why waste your time in building here? Your journey ends with the close of the day. So your journey ends and close of the day. So that is what tautology, end and close, that has the similar meaning. Why waste your time in building here? That is a question mark. So it is interrogation. You never again will pass this way. So you will never again pass this way. So that is our inversion, in which the words are not arranged in the correct order, and you have to write the correct order. And mostly this type of intermixing of the words you will see in the poems. Why will ye here at eventide? Again, here is a interrogation. Old gray head. The pilgrim raised his old and gray, refers to the old age. Okay, so that is tautology. Old and gray refers to the old age. So that is tautology. The chasm which held no fears for me, to the fair-haired youth may a pitfall be. So again, it is inversion. To the fair-haired youth may a pitfall be. So it may be a pitfall to the fair-haired youth. So that is our correct order. So many figures of speech you have seen tautology and inversion in most of the sentences. So last time also we have written the figure of speech. So tautology means that is, words of similar meaning are used in a sentence, and then after tautology there is inversion. That is, words are not arranged in a correct order and you have to make it in a correct order. Okay, so we have done the poem. We have discussed the figures of speech in the poem. Tomorrow we will have the revision of the next lesson, Revati's Musical Class. Till then, goodbye, revise it and prepare poem appreciation as it will come in the exam. Till then, goodbye everyone. Bye.